الثاني نون مسلم ان ذا كيو. If you ask the question in English, it is better. If you can't speak English, ask in Bahasa, but please wear the headphone for the translation for my answer. Your name and your profession, please.
Yang saya hormati Bapak Dr. Zakir Naik dengan rombongannya, para hadirin sekalian yang ada di tempat ini, nama saya adalah Lamsen Naibaho. Tinggal di Bekasi, beragama Kristen Advent, tidak makan babi, tidak minum bir, tidak minum kopi, tidak minum teh, tidak makan anjing, tidak makan belut, tidak makan kuda, dan banyak lagi tidak kami makan karena dilarang oleh Allah melalui Alkitabnya. Kalau melihat dari besarnya acara ini, saat ini rasanya ingin bersyahadat.
Translate, Pak.
Tapi
translate.
Oke.
My name is Lamsen Naiman. Awalnya di Bekasi.
Christian Advent. I do not eat pork. I don't take alcohol, coffee, tea, and many other. Why? Because my God prohibit that in the book, in the Bible, in the gospel, because it is prohibited in the gospel. I don't eat pork, I don't drink, take alcohol, coffee, tea, dog, and etc. Yes? And looking into this very big program tonight, actually, I would like to declare my shahada.
MashaAllah. MashaAllah. Brother says that he's a Christian. He doesn't have alcohol, he doesn't have pork, he doesn't have coffee. And in this gathering, he wants to declare his shahada. Brother, I'd like to ask you, that do you believe that there is one God?
Saya yakin dan percaya bahwa Tuhan itu adalah satu, Esa.
I believe that God is one.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is the Almighty God or is he a messenger of God? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is he God or is he a messenger of God?
Nanti akan terjawab di dalam pertanyaan saya.
I will answer in my question.
Your question is already over. I am asking you, though you said that you want to declare the Shahada. So I am asking you, do you believe Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, to be God or to be a messenger of God?
Sampai saat ini, saya percaya bahwa Yesus adalah Tuhan.
I believe right now that Jesus is God.
Brother,
Tuhan dan manusia.
God and man.
Can you point out a single unequivocal statement from anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says, any unambiguous statement where he himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me? Where does Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, say anywhere in the Bible that he is God or where he says worship me?
Nanti akan terjawab dalam pertanyaan saya.
I will answer in my question later.
There is only one question you can ask. For later question, you have to go behind in the queue.
Yeah. Tanya satu pertanyaan.
You have already finished your question. Your question is over. Do you have any question? Then ask. If your question is over, then only I start speaking. Unless your question is not over, I don't start speaking. I thought your question was over. If you have any question, ask the question first.
Okay, terima kasih. Tadi saya mengatakan sepertinya saya mau bersyahadat melihat besarnya acara ini. Tapi ada tiga pertanyaan yang ada di dalam hati saya yang tidak bisa saya jawab. Dan inilah menjadi penghalang saya untuk bersyahadat. Tapi saya yakin dan percaya bahwa Bapak Dr. Zakir Naik bila bisa menjawab pertanyaan saya, bila bisa menjawab pertanyaan saya melalui Al-Quran, saya bersyahadat.
Right, I have three questions which still hinder me from declaring my belief to be Muslim. These three questions, if you can answer based on Quran, I will declare my shahada. Yeah. Yes, the question please. Langsung Pak, pertanyaannya langsung Pak.
Pertanyaan saya mohon berikan waktu kepada saya. Pertanyaan ini antri, tapi sabar. Demi kebenaran, demi kebaikan. Saya bertanya dahulu. Jika di dalam pertanyaan saya nanti saya menggunakan ayat-ayat suci Al-Quran, ingin bertanya kepada seluruh hadirin, apakah saya dinyatakan menista agama atau menghina Al-Quran? Karena di dalam pertanyaan saya banyak menggunakan ayat-ayat suci Al-Quran. Tidak menista? Oke. Al-Quran berkata,
brother,
dalam Quran surat 9 ayat 22.
Brother, I think you want to give a speech.
Isa lahir.
Brother, wait. I think you want to give a speech. You. Your question should be short. Two or three sentences. You are giving such a long speech. I think you are a speaker. I am a dai. I have met many Christian missionaries. I have met many pastors. I have met many fathers. Please, brother, ask the question brief. Two or three sentences. Not more. Though you are speaking Bahasa. If you speak for more than two or three sentences, it will not be entertaining. You have already spoken more than 15-20 sentences, brother. Do you understand? Yes or no? Do you understand me?
Okay.
Your question should be two or three sentences. Brother, what's your name? What is your name?
Lamson Naibaho.
And what's your profession?
Saya pensiunan PNS dan menjadi pembawa berita baik.
Retired government official.
Pose your question in two or three sentences. There are many people waiting in the queue. We cannot do injustice. Short question. Don't give background. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Cuma saya takut kurang dipahami. Jadi pertanyaan saya ini saya agak panas. Okay, saya siap. Saya siap menanya dengan singkat. Pertanyaan saya.
Okay, wait. What did you say?
Apakah Isa itu asli?
Wait, brother, wait. Two or three sentences, please.
Okay.
Do you understand two or three? What do you say two or three in Bahasa?
Okay.
Dua atau tiga?
Dua tiga.
Ya.
Dua tiga. Kelas.
Okay.
What? Okay. Dua tiga. Mas.
Pertanyaan saya hanya satu barangkali, tidak bisa tiga?
What's this question?
Hanya satu?
If you do not ask your question in the next two sentences, we will ask the next person to come on the microphone.
Okay.
You are wasting the time of more than 50,000 people, brother. I am very kind.
Okay, saya
I am kind,
satu.
But we cannot waste the time. You are wasting the time.
Okay, tidak.
You can hire the auditorium
hanya
tomorrow and call
pertanyaan.
The people, please.
Hanya.
Ask your question
saya.
Directly. Only ask one question which is the most important.
Satu pertanyaan. Apakah Isa itu Yesus?
Is Isa the prophet is Jesus?
I think you did not hear my lecture. I think you did not hear my lecture. I said in my lecture that we be no Muslim as a Muslim unless he believes in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Every Muslim, if he has to be a Muslim, he has to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of God. Brother, did you hear my lecture? Brother, did you hear my lecture?
Saya di negara Indonesia.
Did you hear my lecture,
ada.
Yes or no? Don't give speeches. Did you hear my lecture, yes or no?
Kurang paham.
I actually just understand fully.
So if you did not hear my lecture, is it right to ask me a question? I said in my lecture, it is compulsory. Every Muslim should believe in Jesus, peace be upon him. Why didn't you take a translation headphone? There are hundreds and thousands of headphones here. Why did not you take a headphone? Brother, ask him, why didn't he take a headphone?
He used.
Whose fault is it? My fault or your fault? Why didn't you take this headphone?
Tidak dipersiapkan oleh panitia, jadi saya tidak bawa lagi.
His question is Jesus is same with Isa, is same person.
Yes, Jesus and Isa alayhi salam is same. In Arabic we say Isa, in other languages they twist it and they make it Jesus. He is the one and the same person.
Okay, masih bisa bertanya selanjutnya.
Can he ask second question?
Okay, short and sweet.
Yeah, cepat.
Kalau Isa itu Yesus, apakah pernah ada terjadi peristiwa pembunuhan Yesus atau penyalipan Isa?
If Isa is Jesus, was there actually the crucifixion of Jesus or Isa? Crucification. Yes. If Isa is Jesus, was there too that he was crucified?
Okay, now I would want the translator to translate while I'm giving the answer. Are you listening?
Mendengar.
Okay, now listen carefully to my answer. The question Jesus asked, that was Isa alayhi salam or Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, crucified. You want to know who was crucified? Jesus or Isa? Is that your question?
Iya, benar.
Is it Jesus or is it Isa? That's what you want to know.
Tadi saya pertanyaan pertama, apakah Isa Yesus? Kalau Isa itu Yesus, apakah pernah Yesus atau Isa pernah disalib, dibunuh, mati dan bangkit kembali?
My first question is that Isa is the same with Jesus.
Correct.
It is the same.
Yes.
Was he crucified?
Okay. The reply is given in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 157. Wama qataluhu wama qatalu wama salabu. It starts with saying, wa qawlihim, innal qatalna al-masih Isa ibn Maryam Rasulullah. They said in boast the Jews that we killed Jesus, the son of Mary. Wama qataluhu wama salabuhu. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. Walakin shubbi halum. It was only made to appear so. All those who differ are full of doubts. They are full of doubts. Illatibazan, with only conjectures to follow. For truly they killed him not. Wama qatulu yaqina. So according to the Quran, he was not killed, he was not crucified. The next verse, Surah Nisa chapter 5 verse 158 says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him up alive unto himself. As far as the Quran is is concerned, Quran is very clear, very explicit. Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse number 157, Jesus Christ peace be upon him was not killed, he was not crucified. Now I'll give you the answer from your Bible.
Okay.
Shaitana. Do you believe in the Quran, brother? Do you believe in the Quran?
Kalau pertanyaan
Do you believe in the Quran, yes or no?
Sampai saat ini belum.
No, I will give you the answer from your Bible. Do you believe in the Bible?
Percaya Injil.
Do you believe in the Bible?
Yes, percaya Injil. Yes.
Okay. I have given a talk, crucifixion or crucifixion, or was Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, really crucified? Time will not permit me to give the full lecture and the debate. I'll give you only one sign. If you read the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, it says, when people ask Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, O Lord, O Master, will you show us miracles and signs? So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, replies, ye men of iniquity, you evil people, you ask for a sign, no sign shall be given to you except the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is putting all his eggs in one basket. He says, you evil and adulterous generation, seeketh thee after a sign, no sign shall be given to you but the sign of Jonah. Brother, do you know the sign of Jonah? Brother, do you know sign of Jonah? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Pertanyaannya kurang jelas, terlalu panjang. Jadi singkat-singkat saja.
Yes or no? Why are you giving 10-20 words? Do you know the sign of Jonah? Yes or no? Do you know the sign of Jonah? Yes or no? Do you know Prophet Jonah? Do you know Prophet Jonah?
Oh, Yunus tahu, tahu.
No, yes, he
tahu Yunus.
He knows.
Why don't you translate?
Jonah saya enggak tahu. Yunus tahu. Yes, yes, he knows.
You translate everything what he says. Now why are you keeping quiet?
Yes. He knows the prophet of Jonah.
Every Christian has to know the sign of Jonah because they teach him on even in Sunday school. The sign of Jonah, if you read the Bible, in the book of Jonah, it is hardly one and a half side. Almighty God asked Prophet Jonah, in the Quran it is Yunus, in the Quran Yunus alayhi salam, to go and deliver the message to the people of Nineveh. He goes to Joppa thinking the people of Nineveh will not understand him, will not follow the message. While he's going in a boat, a storm comes. It was a superstition of that time that a storm comes in the sea when someone disobeys his master. So the people want to try out lots. Who in the ship has disobeyed his master so that we can throw him overboard? Jonah, being a prophet of God, he volunteers. I am the prophet of God. I have disobeyed my master. Throw me overboard. When they throw Jonah in the sea, I want to ask you the question. Was Jonah dead or alive? According to the Bible.
Berdasarkan cerita atau sejarahnya dalam Alkitab. Ia hidup di dalam perut ikan.
Brother, why are you giving sentences? I'm asking him, dead or alive? One word you should say. Why are you giving sentences?
Hidup di dalam perut ikan.
And
life.
Why don't you open your mouth, brother?
Yes, life.
If you cannot give the microphone to him, whenever he opens his mouth, you reply, nah? Don't wait for me to stop.
Yes.
Life. He, now Prophet Jonah, is thrown in a storm. In a storm, when a person puts in a storm, when the person is put into a storm, he ought to die. But according to the Bible, was Jonah dead or alive? Dead or alive?
Dia hidup di dalam perut ikan.
Life.
Okay. A fish comes and gobbles him up. When a fish comes and gobbles a man ought to die. Was Jonah dead or alive according to the Bible?
Hidup. Life.
Very good. Alive, alive, alive. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. 3 days and three nights, the fish, according to the Bible, takes him around. Heat, suffocation in the belly of the fish. Any human being ought to die. according to the Bible, was Jonah dead or alive?
Saya yakin dan percaya Allah itu maha kuasa, maha
mampu. I believe that God is almighty.
Okay, alive, dead or alive?
Hidup.
Alive.
Yes. Hidup. Yes.
And hidup. For dead?
Hidup, life. Hidup.
Hidup.
Yes.
And for hidup. Dead?
For dead, mati.
Mati.
Yes.
Mati or hidup?
Yes.
Mati or hidup? Hidup, alive. The fish gobbles up. The fish vomits out Jonah on the beach. Was Jonah dead or alive? Hidup or mati?
Hidup.
MashaAllah. Alive. Miracle of a miracle. When a person is thrown overboard in a storm, he ought to die. Jonah was alive. A fish comes and gobbles up, yet he's alive. 3 days and three nights suffocation, yet he's alive. He's vomited on the shore, yet he's alive. Alive. Miracle of a miracle. Now Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, "For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth." When Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was put up on the cross, for crucifixion, a person ought to die. Crucifixion, according to the Oxford Dictionary, means a person is put to death on the cross. After Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was taken on the cross, he was put in a sepulcher in the heart of the earth. According to the Bible, was Jesus Christ dead or alive?
Di dalam kubur dia mati.
He died.
That means he did not fulfill the prophecy. That means Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lied. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, "No son shall be given to you except the sign of Jonah. As Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth." If Jonah was alive, even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, should be alive. If he's dead, that means he didn't fulfill the prophecy. Do you mean to say Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lied? Was Jesus Christ a liar? I love Jesus Christ. If you say that, I will get angry. How dare you say that Jesus Christ was a liar, peace be upon him? Brother, did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lie? Did he lie, yes or no? Yes or no?
Saya tidak bisa mengatakan dia bohong karena maksud dan tujuan ayat itu berbeda.
I cannot say something.
You cannot say. Are but the Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is saying in your Bible that as Jonah was, if Jonah was alive, he has to be alive. It is so clear cut. Why do you think he's dead? Where does it say in the Bible he was dead? He never claimed that he was dead. You are thinking wrong. Should you believe in the Bible or not? Are you a Christian?
Saya Christian.
Yes.
So why don't you believe in the Bible? Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38. Don't you believe in the prophecy of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him? Do you believe or not?
Perumpamaan yang diberikan Yesus bukan seperti itu.
The example given by Jesus is not like that.
Dengan saya berbeda.
The example given by Jesus is not like that, you said.
I am quoting to you Gospel of me. You make me understand what is the sign of Jonah. You make me understand. If you know the Bible better than me, make me understand. What is the sign of Jonah? Tell me. Educate me.
Saya bukan mengatakan lebih paham.
I don't say that I have understanding better than you.
Pemahaman kita berbeda.
I don't think that I have understanding better than you.
If you don't have understanding better than me, then follow me. So according to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, fulfilled the sign of Jonah. He was put on the cross, but he did not die on the cross. Same thing as the Quran says, "Wama qataluhu wama salabuhu." They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. It was only made to appear so. Appear so.
Okay.
Okay, so do you believe Jesus wasn't crucified? according to the Bible, forget the Quran. Do you believe Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified? Do you believe? If you don't believe, then what is the use of talking to you?
Mati di tiang salib.
Yeah, he is dead in the cross.
Where does the Bible say that? I am quoting to you Bible. Jesus Christ prophesied, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights. Do you mean to say Jesus Christ lied, peace be upon him? Do you want to call Jesus Christ a liar, nauzubillah?
Kesamaannya.
Brother, do you want to call Jesus Christ a liar?
Kesamaannya.
Jesus Christ, answer my question. Do you want to call Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, a liar?
Tidak bohong.
No.
Correct. So he said he will be alive, so why are you saying he's dead? Are you following the teachings of Jesus Christ or Zakir Naik? Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38. I'm giving you the reference. Are you following the teachings of Jesus Christ or me, Zakir Naik? Who is a better Christian, you or me? Who is a better Christian, you or me?
Bukan masalah lebih baik dan lebih pintar dan lebih tahu.
It is not
tapi pemahaman Zakir Naik dengan pemahaman saya sangat berbeda,
but
seperti langit dan bumi.
Is really different from yours.
If you are different, that means you don't believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. My thing is Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Even according to the Bible, he did not die on the cross. He was not crucified. So who told you he was crucified? Who told you? Where did you get this from?
Jelas tercatat di dalam Matius dan Markus, Yesus tersalib dan mati. Tapi
itu Bible
Quran mengatakan tidak mati tersalib.
Wait.
Dan yang menjadi pertanyaan kembali ke awal.
Let me have the translation. Wait. What did he say?
It is clearly written in the Matthew, in the Bible, in the Matthew.
Where? Which verse? Tell me. Chapter number, verse number. Tell me.
Saya tidak mungkin saya bacakan malam ini, tapi saya tidak bohong. Yesus,
it is impossible. Stop.
Wait.
Stop. It is impossible for me to read it now.
So whose fault it is? I've been asking this question for 25 years on the Peace TV channel. Get me one verse. I have had debates with your doctor of divinity. I have had debates with your bishops, with your pastor.
Matius 27.
Okay, who is your most famous pastor in Indonesia? Brother, who is your most famous pastor in Indonesia?
Pastor, saya tidak percaya kepada pastor. Hanya percaya kepada Alkitab.
I don't believe in the priest. I believe in Alkitab.
You believe it?
Al-Kitab, believe in the Bible.
Al-Kitab, you don't know the Kitab, I know the Kitab. If you believe in the Kitab, I'm talking about the Bible. Why don't you believe in the Bible? Do you think I'm lying? If you don't know who's to blame, you are to blame, not me. So according to the Bible and according to the Quran, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified, he was not killed. What is the third question? What is the third question?
Pertanyaan ketiga apa, Pak?
Pertanyaan berapa? Ketiga?
Ketiga.
Pertanyaan saya tadi, kalau ada peristiwa penyalipan, siapakah yang tersalib itu?
If there was crucifixion, who was crucified?
I think the brother did not hear the translation of the Quran I said. Quran is very clear cut in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 150, and I'm repeating it. وَقَوْلِيهِمْ إِنَّ الْقَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيُّ إِسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَا. They said in both the Jews, we killed Jesus, the son of Mary. وَمَا قَتَلُهُ وَمَا صَلَبُهُ. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. It was only made to appear so. All those who differ are full of doubts. إِلَّا تِبَا ذَنْ. With only conjectures to follow. For a yaqeena, they killed him not. That means the Quran is very explicit. They did not kill him, neither did they crucify him. It was made to appear so. Who was crucified? I am not bothered in knowing. When Quran says, I should not be bothered. Why should I be bothered? Whoever was crucified, I don't know. Why should I be bothered? Okay. I'm bothered about Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. When the Quran says Jesus wasn't crucified, peace be upon him. When the Bible says he was not. If somebody else was, why should I be bothered? I should only be bothered whether Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he himself was crucified or not. From the Quran I come to know he was not. From the Bible I come to know he was not. So why should I, when you are not doing research on Jesus, peace be upon him, why should I do research on somebody else? Hope that answers the question. I'm not bothered who was crucified. As long as Jesus, peace be upon him, wasn't crucified, the Quran is very clear. All those who differ are full of doubt. I don't want to waste my time in doing research. Who was crucified? Was he or was he not? I am very clear. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, wasn't crucified. Hope that answers the question.